Hey everyone, welcome to Data is Easy. So today we are going to look into the introduction of machine learning. So what is machine learning? So if you Google, you will see so many applications around machine learning. But the essence of each definition is that machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence where the machine learns by itself without any human intervention in order to give accurate predictions. Okay, so human intervention is basically only required to define the problem statement, decide upon the dependent variables, and provide data to the machine. And ML actually uses some kind of algorithms to learn from the data in order to give the predictions. Okay, and we realize it or not, machine learning has become an integral part of every facet of life. Some of its daily life applications are friend suggestion on Facebook, which you must have seen so many times on your Facebook profile, movie suggestions on Netflix, and product recommendation on e-commerce websites, which you must have seen again on Amazon or any other e-commerce website that you use. Now let's try to understand machine learning by an example. This might sound a little hypothetical one, but it will give you a clear idea about machine learning concept. Let us say you have a nice small kitten at your home. Okay, and you are always worried about its safety from the dogs. Okay, and it is not possible for you to be around the kitten all the time. So what you will do, you will basically get a machine and install some kind of AI on it. Okay, and you will give it hundreds or thousands of pictures of dogs and similarly hundreds of thousands of pictures of other animals. Okay, and you will give it to learn. Okay, and machine will basically learn by itself that what is dog and what is not. So tomorrow, if some other unknown dog comes to the entrance of the house where you have installed this machine, it will basically recognize the dog. Okay, because it has already learned what is dog. When it sees something similar, then it will basically recognize it and it will start making the scary noises to shoo it away. Okay, so that is the basic concept of machine learning. You have to give it some data to learn, and next time you give it some data which it has not seen before, but it will still be able to recognize or predict that. Okay, now how many types of machine learning algorithms are there? So these can be divided on the basis of two categories. The first one is the type of target variable. Okay, and on the basis of the type of the target variable, we can divide machine learning algorithms into two categories. The first one is classification, where our algorithm basically predicts a class or a category. For example, if you want to recognize whether an animal is dog or not, so that is a category, dog or not dog. These are categories. Okay, so if you have to predict that or recognize that, then you will be using classification algorithms. And the example of the classification algorithms are logistic, decision tree, classifier, and many more. Okay, and the next set of algorithms are regression algorithms, where you basically predict a real number, not a class or category, but a real number. For example, if you want to predict a house price, okay, or a car's price, then you will use regression algorithms. And the examples are linear regression, ridge regression, and again many more. Okay, now the second categorization of the machine learning algorithm is on the presence of target variable. Okay, so if your target variable is present in the data, then it is a supervised algorithm and your data will be labeled. What do I mean by labeled? Is basically you are providing an image. Okay, and you are saying that this image is dog's image, and then next image you are providing and you are telling it categorically that it is a cat's image. Okay, and then you ask the algorithm to learn and predict whether a new image is of dog's image or cat's image. Okay, and the example is same in the previous example where we saw that machine has to recognize the dog. So that was a supervised algorithm problem. Okay, and the examples are regression algorithms or classification algorithms. All kind of regression and classification algorithms basically try to recognize or predict the target variable. Okay, Now, next set of algorithms are unsupervised algorithms, where we just provide the data to the machine, but we don't tell it basically. These are not labeled, these are unlabeled. Okay, we don't tell the machine whether this one is dog or this one is cat. We just provide the data. Okay, so there is no concept of target variable, right? Because we are not trying to recognize or predict any kind of thing. Here we were supposed to predict whether unknown image is of dog or cat, right? But here there is no such problem statement. There is no target variable. We are just providing the data or images to the algorithm. Okay, all we are asking is to categorize the data, right? So for example, let's say you are a CEO of a company, okay, and you want to group the customers together and provide some kind of service offers. So at high level, you want to group the customers to understand the profile, okay? So how many types of customers are there? Let's say there are three types of customers, five types of customers, okay? So what you will do, you will just submit the profile of all the customers to a unsupervised algorithm, and what it will do, it will basically categorize that this is one category of customers, this second category of customer, third category of customer, like that. So all the customers inside one category will be homogeneous, okay, and they will be heterogeneous from other categories. Okay, yeah, so it will basically categorize the data. It will not predict, or it will not, you know, recognize. It will just categorize the data into different categories on the basis of how they are homogeneous within each category and how they are heterogeneous from other categories. Okay, yeah, so algorithms that can be used for this kind of problem statements are all clustering algorithms like k-means, hierarchical, etc. Okay, clear? Now, you must have heard this term called model multiple times, right? So these machine learning algorithms actually build a model by learning from the data. Okay, so this is data, and then you feed that data to ML algorithm, okay, and then it builds a model, okay, or we can say that it trains a model. Okay, so this model can be considered as input output box. So it takes input from one side and gives output from other side. Okay, let us say you have data of 100k houses. Okay, you have their descriptions like how many bedrooms are there, okay, how many bathrooms are there, what is the size of each house. Okay, like that, you have many such variables, and you also have prices. So in this case, you will provide this data to ML algorithm and you will train a model, and in this case these will be your independent variable and this will be your target variable. I will talk about independent and target variable later, but basically you are trying to predict the price of the house on the basis of all these descriptions or all these information. And once your model is trained, and next time you provide information of a particular house which this model has not seen before, for example, 4 bedrooms, okay, 2 bathrooms, and 2000 square feet, okay, and rest all information, but price information is not mentioned here, you will give this data to the model, and then this model will predict the price, let's say as 300k. okay, so that is what model is, right? Now let us see what are independent and target variables. So first of all, talking about independent variables, so these variables are basically completely independent and they are not dependent on any other variable. In house price example above, number of bedrooms, number of bathrooms, size, etc., all of the variables are independent variables, okay, because they are not dependent on other variables. These are also called features or explanatory variables. Okay, now the next set of variables are called target variables. These variables are dependent on other variables. For example, price here, this is target variable, okay, because this is dependent on all of these variables. Okay, now so these are also called dependent or target variables. Now coming to the last section of this tutorial, what is performance metrics? So it is very crucial to measure the performance of a model. There are many metrics available to test the performance of a model, but these metrics are used on the basis of the problem statement or target variables. But primarily, all these metrics talk about the difference between predicted value and actual value of an observation. So this is also called error term. Okay, and how do we mathematically write it? This is predicted value of one observation minus actual value of that observation divided by n. Let's say if there are n such observations and you will sum them, I equal to 1 to n. For example, your predicted price is of 5 houses. Okay, let's say for one of them you predicted 300, for another one you predicted 400, 500, 500 and 700, whereas, and these are predicted values, whereas the actual values were, let's say 400, 400 and 450, 550 and 600. So the error would be of 100, 0, 50, 50 and 100. Let me use the modular sign here. Okay, so here also error is the modular. Now if I sum them, it will be 100 plus 0 plus 50 plus 50 plus 100, that would be 300. Okay, and there are 5 observations, so error would be 300 divided by 5 equal to 60. So this is your error term. And at high level, all the performance metrics basically try to calculate this error term only. So that is all for now. I hope that you got a sneak peek into machine learning. We will talk about each section in detail in the upcoming videos. Till then, happy learning. Take care. Bye-bye. For example, you predicted for 5 of the houses. Okay. For example, you predicted prices of 5 houses. Okay. Let's say for one of them you predicted 300, for another one you predicted 400, 500, 500, and 700. Whereas, and these are predicted values, whereas the actual values were, let's say 400, 400 and 450, 550 and 600. So the error would be of 100, 0, 50, 50 and 100. Let me use the modular sign here. Okay. So here also error is the modular. Now if I sum them, it will be 100 plus 0 plus 50 plus 50 plus 100, that would be 300. Okay, and there are 5 observations, so error would be 300 divided by 5 equal to 60. Got it?